Are you curious about ways to naturally cure and heal your thyroid gland? If you are dealing with any dysfunction, hypothyroidism, as well as Hashimoto's and even maybe Graves' disease, this video is going to be extremely impactful for you. Happy Vlogmas! I'm Dr. Melissa Gallagher and I'm so excited to have you join me today. Welcome to Vlogmas! If you are new to my channel, welcome. I hope you will hit the subscribe and bell notification to receive daily Vlogmas videos. I've joined the community of YouTubers offering Vlogmas videos every day leading up to Christmas Day. Today's video is focused on healing and curing your thyroid, particularly reversing any thyroid disease that you might be dealing with naturally. I first want to highlight that I do have already some videos that you can watch there that might be impactful. I'll include links down below where you can grab those. I also have a free thyroid webinar that I'm going to gift to you today that you can dig further into thyroid balancing. But specifically, I want to share with you three ways to cure your thyroid. A lot of the patients that I see in my clinic are dealing with hypothyroidism. That tends to be the more abundant patient type, patient profile that I see. I do work with folks that are dealing with Hashimoto's, that is a form of hypothyroidism, as well as individuals that might be dealing with hyperthyroidism and even Graves' disease. So today's video is particularly focused at nourishing and balancing your thyroid gland. A lot of my patients, when I do testing on their thyroid function, as well as micronutrient panels, I see in my clinic trends where individuals are deficient in minerals, particularly iodine, selenium, chromium, magnesium, as well as other key trace minerals that are helpful at balancing all the enzymatic reactions necessary in your body, but also necessary for thyroid hormone receptivity. We just don't have glandular thyroid receptivity in just the thyroid gland. We have receptivity in all parts of our body. Particularly if you are a female, you are going to have thyroid receptivity in your breast tissue, as well as in your uterine tissue and even ovaries, as well as other glands. So it's really important that we address the core nutrients that you might be deficient in to heal your thyroid. The first way we do that is by adding concentrated trace mineral drops. This is a small little dropper that you can easily carry in your purse or have in your drawer at your office, and you can add in a few drops to your water, your tea, any of your beverages that you might consume daily. This is a very simplified way of really maximizing your mineral intake. Not only will your thyroid gland benefit, but all other glandular, endocrine, body-oriented systems positively benefit because of these trace minerals. We need minerals, and all of us have some degree of mineral deficiency. The second recommendation is probably something that you won't be hearing from your endocrinologist, and that tends to be things that I reveal here on my channel, things you don't get told, you're not aware of, and certainly aren't directed in terms of utilizing as a resource to heal your body. So this particular gland is a gland that you absolutely have to balance and nourish and support if you want to heal your thyroid gland. And it happens to be your adrenal glands. We have two. Most of us have two. I have had patients that only have one kidney and one adrenal gland. But in your current state, if you're equipped with two kidneys, you should have two adrenal glands. And I laugh about that, but I've actually had people who just have one kidney and didn't know it. So at the top of each of your kidneys, left and right side, you have this little, it's like the kind of top of the kidney. It's the adrenal gland. That is what we call our fight or flight gland. Supporting your adrenal glands are crucial because those adrenal glands, when they are dysfunctional, burnt out, running and revving too high, which if you are in any state of stress, feel anxious, have hair loss, difficulty losing weight, feel like you're gaining weight or holding fluid or excess weight in the midsection, maybe you notice you're a little bit more on edge. Well, that's an adrenal thing, as well as high blood pressure. High blood pressure is often factored into an imbalanced adrenal gland, the root cause, I should say. So one of the things that you have to do is you have to support your adrenals. Now there, that's its own topic. And if you want me to dig into that, let me know, comment down below, go yes, tell me more about the adrenals and I'd be happy to do that. So the two best ways to support your adrenal glands is one, add more sleep to your daily intake of sleep. So you could do this in several different ways. Go to bed an hour earlier. You could go to bed a half an hour earlier and wake up half an hour later. You could take a nap for an hour. But sleep, getting more sleep, is the body's natural way of rejuvenating your adrenal glands. So if you are not sleeping or deal with insomnia, that just adds to the cyclical imbalance of the adrenal glands and you're like a hamster on a wheel, not ever improving. A quick second to sleep is to naturally add in what we call adaptogenic herbs into your daily diet. And I'm gonna share with you one of my favorite herbs that I take on the daily. It is a blend of all the herbs that I would recommend. Now, there is a caveat. If you experience Hashimoto's, if you for sure know that you have antibodies and your body's attacking your thyroid gland, which is what Hashimoto's is. If you've been told you have Hashimoto's and you don't know your antibody levels, please find that out because you can get an idea of the range of this autoimmune attack. If you do have Hashimoto's, you have to avoid one of the adaptogenic herbs and it's called ashwagandha. And I'll include a video right there and a link down below. You have to watch that because it explains why you want to avoid this herb if you have Hashimoto's. But most importantly, adrenal supportive adaptogenic herbs are a secondary support to your thyroid gland. And a lot of times we're not making that connection that when the adrenal gland is dysfunctional, it'll weigh on and pull down the thyroid gland. There's a direct connection. And so you want to definitely support your adrenal glands. My third and final tip for you in supporting your thyroid gland is to grab one of my protocols. I've built these protocols. This is after 15 years, over 15 years now, of experience working with patients just like yourselves and feeling like I'm a broken record because a lot of times I'm seeing the same lab values, I'm seeing the same stressors, I'm seeing a lot of the same commonalities and I'm saying the same thing over and over again. I've compiled a protocol that breaks out food, specific guidelines, what you can eat to heal your body, as well as reflexology points that are very pro-supportive of your thyroid gland and other daily things to incorporate and other daily things to avoid, like toxins in our food sources, skincare sources. I include a specific list with all the ingredients that you can canvas your cupboards and all of your drawers and get rid of thyroid-destroying, glandular-destructive, harmful chemicals ingredients that are in our everyday products. So please consider grabbing that download. There'll be a link down below. This will be a great investment for you and your health. And I know you'll be like many of the other hundreds of individuals who are working that protocol at the current moment that are noticing significant changes. So I hope you will take advantage of that. And please comment down below if hearing about the thyroid adrenal gland connection was new to you, and if you want me to dig a little bit further into that. So today's comment winner will win a trio of wonderful things. First, you will win a Natural Health Resources holiday ornament. We're giving these away every Vlogmas video. And I'm including one of our Natural Health Resources notebooks. This is a lined notebook. You can use this to take notes on all my videos. You can use this to take notes as you're researching for your own health plan. It can work out to be a diary, however you want to utilize this, food journal. And I'm giving away a free thyroid, hypothyroid protocol. So these three items will be received by one lucky comment winner. So comment down below, let me know your thoughts. And I want to thank you again for tuning in. Stay tuned tomorrow for another Vlogmas video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And if you want more impactful, insightful, behind the scenes videos, I hope you'll consider joining our membership program here on YouTube. Thanks, friends, for tuning in. See you tomorrow.